Good morning. Today we'll be doing the Liturgy of the Hours morning prayer for July 13th. Today is Saturday in the 14th week of Ordinary Time. Let's have that moment of silence to prepare us for a prayer. God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia.
As morning breaks, we sing of your mercy, Lord, and night will find us proclaiming your fidelity. It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to make music to your name, O Most High, to proclaim your love in the morning, and your truth in the watches of the night, and the stand string, lyre, and the lute, with the murmuring sound of the harp.
Your deeds, O Lord, have made me glad. For the work of your hands I shout with joy. O Lord, how great are your works! How deep are your designs! The foolish man cannot know this, and the fool cannot understand.
Though the wicked spring up like grass, and all who do evil strive, they are doomed to be eternally destroyed. But you, Lord, are eternally on high. See how your enemies perish. All doers of evil are scattered.
To me you give the wild ox strength. You anoint me with the purest oil. My eyes look in triumph on my foes. My ears heard gladly of their fall. The just will flourish like the palm tree and grow like a Lebanon cedar.
Planted in the house of the Lord, they will flourish in the courts of our God. Is still bearing fruit when they are old, is still full of sap, still swinging. To proclaim that the Lord is just, in him my wrath there is no wrong.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
As morning breaks, we sing of your mercy, Lord, and night will find us proclaiming your fidelity.
Extol the greatness of our God. Give ear, O heavens, while I speak. Let the earth hearken to the words of my mouth. May my instructions soak in like the rain, and my discourse ferment like the dew, like a downpour upon the grass, like a shower upon the crops. For I will sing the Lord's renown. O proclaim the greatness of our God. The rock, how faultless are his deeds, how right all his ways, a faithful God without deceit, how just and upright he is.
Yet basely has he been treated by his degenerate children, a perverse and a crooked race.
is the Lord to be thus repaid by you, O stupid and foolish people? Is he not your Father who created you, thus he has made you and established you? Think back of the days of old. Reflect on the years of age upon age. Ask your fathers, and he will inform you. Ask your elders, and they will tell you. When the Most High assigned the nations their heritage, when he parceled out the descendants of Adam, he set out the boundaries of the peoples after the numbers of the Son of God, while the Lord's own portion was Jacob, his hereditary share was Israel. He found them in a wilderness, a wasteland of holy desert. He shielded them and cared for them, guarding them as the apple of his eyes.
As an eagle inside its nestling fort,
by hovering over its brood, so he spread his wings to receive them and bore them up on his pinions. The Lord alone was their leader. No strange God was with him. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Extol the greatness of our God.
How wonderful is your name, O Lord, in all creation.
How great is your name, O Lord, our God, through all the earth. Your majesty is praised above the heavens, on the lips of children and old babes. You have found praise to foil your enemy, to silence the foe and the rebel. When I see the heavens, the work of your hands, the moon and the stars which you arranged, what is man that you should keep him in mind, mortal man that you care for him? Yet you have made him little less than a god. With glory and honor you crowned him, gave him power over the works of your hands, put all things under his feet. All of them sheep and cattle, yes, even the savage beasts, birds of the air and fish, that make their way through the waters. How great is your name, O Lord our God, through all the earth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. How wonderful is your name, O Lord, in all creation.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Bless your persecutors. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Have the same attitude toward all. Put away ambitious thoughts and associate with those who are lowly. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning, my dear friends. A reflection for today is from the Gospel for this Saturday, Gospel according to Matthew. In these verses, Jesus repeated three times, "Do not be afraid," as he sent his apostle to preach the kingdom of God to a world full of hostility. He knew very well the weaknesses and strengths of the people he's sending. There are enough reasons to be afraid. Missionaries are not welcome in many parts of the world. Preachers and priests are martyred. Even ordinary Christians are ridiculed and persecuted by forces seen and unseen. At present, my dear friends, there are wars that have affected millions of people. People have lost their loved ones and their livelihood. We continue to be witnesses of a new Holocaust in Ukraine, in Israel, in Palestine, and in Gaza. Can humanity surmount all of this trouble? Jesus is telling us, do not be afraid. Though the world seems to be in darkness, God who created is in control. He sees everything, including our secrets. He knows everything, including the number of our hair. He can do anything, and no one is above him. Do not be afraid. Though our fear seems to be grow higher and bigger, we have a God who is bigger. He's the God of history. Pandemic came and ended before. Wars happened and ended before. Environmental disasters took place and ended before. Is there any problem that God cannot solve? I don't think so. My dear friends, do not be afraid.
It is my joy, O God, to praise you with song.
It is my joy, O God, to praise you with song.
To sing as I ponder your goodness.
To praise you with song.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
It is my joy, O God, to praise you with song.
Lord, guide our feet into the way of peace.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David.
Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant.
This was his oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life.
You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins.
In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadows of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Lord, guide our feet into the way of peace. Let us celebrate the kindness and wisdom of Christ. He offers his love and understanding to all men, especially to the suffering. Let us earnestly pray to him.
Perfect us in love, Lord.
This morning we recall your resurrection
and we long for the benefits of your redemption.
Grant that we bear witness to you today, Lord,
and offer an acceptable gift to the Father through you.
Enable us to see your image in all men,
and to serve you in them.
Lord Jesus, you are the true vine, and we are the branches.
Allow us to remain in you, to bear much fruit, and to give glory to the Father.
Let us pause for a moment to lift up our prayers and petitions to our Lord Jesus Christ. Dear Lord Jesus, we lift up to you our prayers and our petitions, together with the prayers and petitions of each and everyone who are praying with us this morning. We ask, dear Jesus, that you hear and answer each and every prayer as we pray.
Perfect us in love, Lord. Gathering our prayers and praises into one, we now pray the prayer Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, we praise you with our lips and with our lives and hearts. Our very existence is a gift from you. To you we offer all that we have and are. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for praying with us.
We hope you can hear us again tomorrow.
Same time.
Same place.
Same channel. Have a great day.